is how to pull apart the GK10 portable mobility scooter. So, first thing that we need to know is that with the mobility scooter, it's got two different modes. One is a drive mode and one is a lock mode. The lock mode is basically what enables you to drive the scooter. So this right now is in the neutral mode, okay? So it means that we can push it just like this. Okay, so the lock mode or drive mode is when we push the gear underneath here. It is a yellow button right located near the back of the wheel, and now you'll notice that we cannot push it. Okay, now that we can not push it, we can drive the mobility scooter backwards and forwards. Pulling apart the scooter. Okay, our first job is over here to lift this lever up and the seat will come down. Now that we've done that, underneath the chair, right here there will be a yellow lever that we lift up, wiggle, and then lift the seat off. Here's the yellow lever. Okay, and we'll just put the seat on the ground just up here. Our next step is to take the batteries off. Okay, make sure the scooter's off, of course, because you are disconnecting the power. Okay, what you do is you can take them both off at once. Or if it's a bit heavy, you can take one off at a time. Now, when you charge the mobility scooter, you can take the batteries and charge them straight from the batteries and leave the scooter in the house. Please keep in mind, though, that the batteries do have to be connected together. Otherwise, if you charge only one battery, it's a current that goes through one battery into the second one. And if this battery is completely charged, it will never actually get to the second battery. So just make sure they're both charged when they're locked together. Alright? Now, our first step is to take the front basket off. It's as simple as just pulling it off, okay? We've got our little mechanism. We can see here, we just clip it on. Just like that. Okay? Our final step is here. What we do is we just push that in, just like that. And now we can lower this. We can turn the mirror up so it doesn't damage anything. We'll just put it down like that. Now, if we've got a big enough boot, we can put it in straight like this and have a person at the front to lift. There is a part here where you can lift from. Don't lift from the plastic because you'll just pull the plastic off. Somebody can also lift from the back. Or if it's a bit too hard or you haven't got enough room in the boot, what you do is, here is a yellow lever. You just push that back and then you lift the machine off. Just like that. And then you lift both pieces. You grab here and you grab the front part, put it into the car. You can also lift here and just roll it through the boot of the car, tilt it on, and then get it in that way. And that's the five pieces. When you put it back together, you'll see on here we have two yellow arrows, and on here we also have two yellow arrows. What we do is simply align them, okay, so that this bar here, just fits nice and easy into the machine, okay? Now, you see how it just keeps coming out? It's not actually plugged in correctly. You have to wait till you hear that click. If you're not sure, just lift again, and if you can't lift it off, then it means it's clicked in safely. All right, our next job is to just lift this up once more, just like this. Now, you can adjust the height. Remember our little mechanism here? You can lift it out. So now it clicks right in place. But if we want it a bit closer, we pull it back in. There's three little circles here. So move it closer, lift it out again, and it clicks back in. Okay? It'll become more evident once we've got it in this and we've got the seat on. You'll understand what I mean. Our next step is to put the batteries back in. One at a time. You can see that they're actually not together. You need to make sure that they're nice and together, nice and flat. Okay, if you don't see them together, together, then you're not going to get proper power. Our next step is to get the battery, the basket back on. Just like this. Alright, and then our final step is to get the chair back on. Alright, now, when we're putting the chair back on, just make sure you've got your hand on the mechanism here. Alright, because when you get it back on, you do need to actually click it back into place. The same mechanism that we use to get it out is the same mechanism we use to actually click it back in place. Alright, and it should click into place. Okay, you would have also noticed when I got this up, it'll go straight back down. Just lift it back until it clicks in. That is the complete method of how to pull apart and put this machine back together. Okay, other than that, pretty much very easy to drive. All you've got to remember is your little yellow mechanism. Your key's got a yellow mechanism, okay? Your driving gear's got a yellow mechanism, and pulling apart the machine as well, okay? Thanks for watching.